a video I did a couple weeks ago where I really trimmed this pony's feet and used the mapping just exactly like I use it on a big horse to bring this pony's toes back. Well, where's the pony? There it is. Okay, and so I want you to take a look at this foot here. As I'm actually surprised at the change in it. Where is it? Okay, when I started with her, she had little boxes like this. And over time, I've been able to figure out where the real foot is. And the reason I'm doing an introduction to this is because I took her toes back pretty severely. And I was a little worried about it. But in the end, with her and with Bear, I had really, really good results. And I wanted to show you something on her. I mean, you'll see from this video, it's been about 2 weeks. Would you quit messing around? Okay, it's been about 2 weeks. You'll see that the foot has changed a lot, and I can actually trim it again and get some of the excess foot off. Yeah, okay. See, it used to be she didn't have any angle here at all. There was just a box, just a square little box. Now she's starting to have a foot that looks a little more like a horse's foot. Okay. Okay, I'm here to trim the pony. Say hi, little Jackie. I remember I got this pony last December, a year ago, and I didn't really do much with her feet. Just kind of kept them trimmed to what they were, and they were little square boxes. But there's some interesting things going on with her feet. I haven't really touched her for 6 weeks. First of all, I want you to notice this periopal flap here. It is really thick and detached to right here. I am gonna take all this off, all this heel and all this frog today, because if you look at the side of her foot, you see how high it is from here to here. See, she's got a lot of excess hoof wall in here to begin with, and then her heels are much too long. You can see she's got a lot of concavity isn't always the best thing. You know, it can mean you have too much foot also. She's got a lot of sole in the toe here. What I'm gonna do is, first of all, clean out the foot and map it. Map the toe length. I wanna know my toe length, and then I'm gonna take these heels down. And I mean, this is really interesting, this thickness of periopal flap here. You know, she should be more sitting down more here on her foot. This should be a lower to the ground. See, if you've got bulbs that are clear up in the air like this, you got something wrong. You've got excess hoof wall from here to here that's been jammed up in, excess hoof wall, not down here, grown out the sole. But above the sole, where it connects, the wall connects with the sole, and it has jammed up into here and pushed it up. Okay? So, anyway, I'm going to show you how I'm going to map this little foot. I hope I'm getting that foot. How I'm going to map this little foot and take it all down to what it should be. Okay. Okay, I wasn't going to show you about cleaning out the sole, but instead I am. Again, before I map, I'm going to clean up my sole. See where I'm at here. Oh my goodness. See, that's all dead sole. This pony, like Molly, retains sole. Yeah. Oh, that's live right there. See the different color? It's either this ain't here. This is all dead. Man, that is, there's a lot of dead soul in there. I want to know where the apex of frog is on the pony, because I want to map our toes correctly and know what's going on. Do I have a stretched out toe here or what? Because she's got weird little hooves. Okay. All right. Now I'm getting down there. We'll take off some frog because that's all coming down. I could sharpen my hoof knife and put on another glove. So that I don't slice my finger off. Okay, so I'm pretty much to the apex of the frog. Right there. See, her toes are too long. This way. She's got too much stuff in her, and it's really creating, that's why her heels are growing so fast and more, because the toe has too much depth in her. Like I say, sometimes concavity is good, and sometimes it's not. It just depends. You're wanting a balance here to this foot, and sometimes it's hard to find. We're gonna find her widow foot in here somewhere, in all this mess. Give me that frog. Jeez, Luna, you could sharpen your hoof knife here. I'm for once gonna find where the apex of her frog is. For real. Oh, I still haven't found it. Holy Hannah. It's way back there. I think I found it. Right there. Holy henna, you got a lot of excess foot there, girl. It's been hard to tell where your foot is. Let's take off some of this. The more you learn about the anatomy of the foot, the more you can tell what isn't supposed to be there. Okay, now I'm going to map this foot. Now, again, just like with the big horse. Okay. I'm going to take a little bit of that heel off first. See where I need to get down to. Ho, 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 ho. Oh, little kitten. Okay. Now, find a marker and a ruler. I was using my little square thing, but old habits are hard to break. Now, I want to know where the toe of this pony should be. I'm going to mark the apex of the frog right here. And I'm going to go clear back into here and mark the seat of the corn, the very inside of the heel area here of the sole. I'm going to draw a line across here, like so. Now in between here and here is the center of this pony's foot. So, right, I'm just going to kind of judge it by eye, right about here. Now look at how that run right into that bar right there. Again, right about here. Again, look how it run into the center of the bar. Here is the center of this pony's foot. Now I'm going to come back here and you get this little dimple right here. I'm going to mark right in the center of it. Now I'm going to take my ruler and I'm going to measure from that dimple to this line right here. Then I'm going to take that measurement. I'm going to go up here and I'm going to show you where this pony's sole should end. Gosh dang, that scared me. The pony's sole and foot, the sole should end here. And of course you add to it the wall. You want to put a little bit of wall on there, right there. That's where her wall should be growing down to, is right here. Okay, now, the way that I am going to bring that back is from the top. A lot of people don't have nippers. So I'm going to come up here like this from the front and I'm going to start rasping that toe back. I hope you can see this. If I had that right here. Nope. If I hold that right there. Hope you can see that. Now, this is how you can do it if you don't have a hoof stand. Since I have a hoof stand, I'm not going to do that and you do all that work. Instead, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to mark up here. See where my line goes right there, where the wall should be? I'm going to mark on the outside of the hoof capsule here and here. Okay. And then I'm going to take it off from the top on the hoof stand. I'm doing the same thing. It's just that I'm fortunate to have. I'm fortunate to have a, whatchamacallit, hoof stand. Okay, so I'm just gonna take this back like this. Quit. See, I see my lines here. Now this is stretched forward toe, and that's why you're getting that color. Now I'm taking it off about all the way across from line to line, but I've left it a little rounded. Give it here. Now we'll look at the bottom.
Come here. Come here. Give me your foot.
Okay. Leave it here.
Please bring me a home if she's
done anything. What smell?
You don't smell that? Funky like death.
Okay, you can see the thick periopal flap here. I'm going to cut those off, and I'm going to take the heels and the sides of the wall down. Now you can see the difference here in these toes. In this toe, which now has been shortened back, and in this toe, lift it up, which is stretching forward. See it there? Okay, now you can see how much I've cut that frog down to normal. And where I'm gonna take the heels off and the sides of the foot here on this pony to try and get a little better balanced foot. Not such a box with so much wall in the sides to where she's standing up on her toes. Okay, so here's this dimple in the back. I want my heels to be even pretty much with that. Maybe a little higher than that, not much. Okay, since I have nippers, I'm gonna nip this out here. Side of the foot. There, starting to look more like a normal foot now. Instead of all this weirdness of growth. Now I'm gonna clean it up again. As you see, there's still dead sole there. Now I took a bunch off the side here. take a bunch up here too. Up here. Sometimes it's hard to find the true foot of the horse. That's why mapping is important. Because once you get that toe down, see, she's got bruising. This is bruising in her. Okay, now I'm gonna kind of finish it off by rasping it. Slightly round that off there. There we go. Again, this pink you see here is bleeding from a stretched toe and bruising in here from the toe being stretched and from there being too much pressure on the toe. The coffin bone is below the apex of the frog here. You know, so the coffin bone is, let's see, it would be clear up in here. See how much further that is up there? Okay, now I'm not gonna, in this case, since I've taken her toe down a little bit like that, I'm not going to bevel the sides of the wall. I'm gonna let her get used to this and let the toe grow in a little bit. And then I'll bevel some in the side. Well, I don't know, I need to knock off just the very edge. It's just a judgment call. There. Hold on, little pony. Just knock off the edge. There we go. Okay. Now let's let her foot down. And we'll take a look at it. Okay, there we go. That's what it looks like now from the side. Now, you can see where this pony's toe was very flared out to here. Okay, in order to get this to grow down straight, like it's supposed to, it's still flared from here to here. Okay, but you have to have the leverage off of the front of this wall. And that's just all there is to it. The longer you keep the lever on a toe, like that other one, you'll just never get that thing to come back the way it should. You know, now you can see she's got a little better angle here. She's not standing up. You know, this toe will come back more form-fitted to her foot. So, you know, there might be some people don't like seeing that little bit of pink in there, in that toe. But as I said, her coffin bone's clear up here. You know, it's below the frog, okay? So, anyways, and up above the sole. So, you know, didn't hurt her at all. Now she'll be able to walk better without constant pulling on her toes. Alrighty. Okay, there you can see the difference. How when that horse breaks over, she's not pulling that toe out. Okay, now as I said, you're getting ready to watch the video I did 2 weeks ago of shortening this horse's foot. And you'll see in that video where I basically took her heels down right here. This is where the periopal flaps were. And you'll also see in the video that I've got a big chunk of periopal flap loose that, and I took the heels down a lot in the video 2 weeks ago to where the periopal flap was and cut off a lot of frog. And see, what you're gonna know is, see, there was this much hoof wall like this on this pony right here, and the frog had grown all up to it. It was hard to tell where the real foot was. You better stand up. Okay, and so you'll see the way I mapped the toe and brought it back in the foot. It's done nothing but improve it, and you're gonna see here in this pony that she's ready for a complete trim again just in 2 weeks, and that's because of all the excess foot that she had. Look here at the back of her foot. Okay, a horse's foot is not supposed to be like this. She's got this still this much too much frog and too much hoof wall, but I couldn't take it off all at once and stuff. Slowly her foot is adjusted. It's starting to look more like a horse. And we're gonna trim her again today and take out. All right, now I can tell you I can take out a whole bunch of sole there and everything else. I'll do just like I did in the video you're gonna see now, but it's only 2 weeks later. Now, can't always do it 2 weeks later, but in her, her foot is changing enough that I can do this. I need to do this now. Okay. Okay, again, mapping a pony, same as mapping a big horse. You're gonna, you know, you're gonna want to clean up your heel area and stuff back here so you can find the seat of the corn. Make sure it's back, you know, to the, at least back in here. You mark it, see the corn. Well, I didn't do that very good. Find the apex of the frog. I dig down there. It's probably about right there. Right in between here, here and here, at the seat of the corn, is the center of the foot. Right here. And you also see her bars end right here. So I'm just right on there. If I was to draw a line right there, right across here, and get right in the center, I'd run right into the bars. So there's the center of her foot. Now, then you want to come back here. You got a little dimple here at the back of the central sulcus that goes like this. Right there. And you would measure that. You would measure that from that dimple to the center of the foot, which is right here. And then from here to the toe. Now this is where her sole should end. Okay, now last time it was clear up, it was her toe was even further. You'll see in the video coming up. Okay, her wall should be growing down to right here. Okay, and this ridge of sole that grows around here should actually grow around the ridge of the coffin bone, which is right in here. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just clean that up a little bit, show you what I can do to it real quickly. Okay, first of all, she's ready to take out more sole, as you will see also in the video, more bar. I'm gonna take down the seat of the corn. See, that is dead sole there. Now remember, I want you to look at the video that's coming up as the one that I just did this 2 weeks ago to her. But see, she had a lot of excess foot in a lot of different places. Now see, I'm cleaning out the seed of the corn. Get all the dead soil out here. It's got a little bruising in here. This is the little redness you see from having a long toe. Okay, I can take off this frog right here. Because I'm going to be able to take her heels down. Take off a little more right there. Take a little bit of that in there. We're finally finding her central sulcus here. Okay, now I can even cut down some of these heels. As you'll see here, right there. Yep. Yes, her foot is looking more like a pony foot now instead of a little box. Okay, and I'm gonna cut off the front of that toe. Oops. Just a little bit. Right there. I'm bringing my breakover back to this line more. Okay, so that's what I did today, and you'll see from the other video that I did just 2 weeks ago, her foot is looking more like a horse's foot now than a square box. Okay. See, I wanted to show you this periopal flap, how it's loose clear to here. There. All right. Okay, I want you to see that I took the toe back a whole bunch more this time. And I also want you to see, as you know, where I was so worried about that red spot at the toe that was kind of not really red but pinkish, like I was getting into the quick. As you see, it's not quite like that at all now. I think that was some bruising and blood from the toe being pulled forward, actually. And so I've been able to take the toe back even more, if you can see that, than I did in the video that you just watched. Again, this is 2 weeks later. Look how much rounder, look how bigger the frog is, more wide at the base. I've been able to take the heels down and the toe back and down as well. So, you know, I'm really happy. She's finally walking on the base of her foot here rather than it being stuck up in the air. And so, I'll show you this. Right there. That's what it looks like. Hope you can see it. I can't tell if I'm getting it or not. So I want you to look at it compared to the other foot there. Okay. You see how, where am I at here? Okay. You see how big that foot is there compared to this one here. You know, this is starting to look like a real horse's foot now instead of a box. But it's gone through a lot of weird changes trying to get it that way and trying to find the real foot. So, there you go. You see how big that one is? High in the back. Okay, so slowly that toe is coming back. Now this should grow down eventually back to here. You know, right now it's still kind of going like that. All right.
See her.